By Andrew, a three, off the rim, it's over. 55-52, Worcester Tech is your D4 boys state champion.
It was a back and forth game. Never doubt that these guys can come back when they're down, because they've been down during the season, they've been down in this playoff run we had, and they were always able to come back because they don't give up, and that's they're mentally tough, and mentally they're strong. But we, you know, the last possession of the game was a little tricky. We were up three, and I think it was like 4 seconds left, and they had the ball coming out of bounds, and we knew they were going to try to get it to their best player. And they were able to get it to their best player, and he had a step over half court heave that he threw up, and fortunately, it went a little bit to the left, I think.
On that last play, they inbounded it to their big man. We tried to deny the ball to their best player, and he happened to get it at like half court. And when the shot went up, it looked good. It came off very, very close. And when it bounced out, it was just that relief that we did it, and it's just excitement. It blows out. It's just great, you know. You're so excited. You win it. You won the state championship. It was a loss for words in the moment.
When the ball got into the Andrews kid, we just had to make sure we gave him the toughest look that we possibly could. We didn't want the ball into him, but it just worked out that he got the ball, but he didn't make it. That's all that mattered.
Because I was the one who had to like deny him. I denied him at first, and then he did a little cut through, and he caught the ball. And I was hoping, please, don't make this shot. So I went up to contest my son went up to contest, and I think another guard went up to contest. And he shot it, and I looked, and it went off, and I was so happy.
The roll and rally that the school gave to us was outstanding. It was one of the best things I've ever been a part of. It was great, all the support the kids received from the administration, the student body, faculty, staff. It was a great send-up for the big game.
The rolling rally was amazing, having all the student body and the teachers just showing their support for us and how hard we worked just to get here, and then them being on our side and being behind us. It's just great.
It was fun. You know, I got to skip class for a little bit, go through the halls with everybody cheering. It was a good experience.
When we had the rolling rally, it was a great feeling. To see all the students and how they supported us and all that. It just felt good to know we had support. This is something we're going to be able to look at from 20, 40, 50 years now, from now, and just be able to say, like, we were the first team in the city to win a championship on any level, and it just feels great. We're going to come back to the school, practice with the guys, and we're going to know that when they keep on winning next year and the years after that, we're going to know that we started it all.
Yeah, yeah. Definitely, this is an experience that I probably won't ever forget.
Always, I'm definitely going to remember it the rest of my life. You know, coming back to the city where I grew up and where I'm raised, I could come to my school, Worcester Tech, and look up and see that my year's up there in a banner, and that I was on that team that won the first state championship and for public schools.
Being the first Worcester Public School to win a state championship in boys basketball, I think is a huge accomplishment for this team. We're very proud of what these guys did.
I just want to say thank you to all the community and all the fans that showed out to our game. And I just want to say thank you to the student body and our teachers at our school. And for the city of Worcester, it's amazing.
We did it. Mama, we made it.
How are you?
Good.
I love your ears.
Can I go on the floor?
Sure.
every time you come to the bank to make your deposit, we give you a punch and your key tag. And when it's all filled up, you get to choose from one of the prizes over here. For today, you get to thank you.
We get to learn how to save, spend, and share responsibly with Country Bank.
I'm excited to do banking because most children don't get to do it, but we're lucky Country Bank came to our school.
And when this is all filled up, Brooklyn, you'll get to choose your prize, okay? Thank you.
I think that it is important to begin learning about the importance of money at an early age, especially now in a time when we have debit cards and students really don't handle money, and just gives them a sense of ownership of what belongs to them. And having this partnership early on in life, I think it's very beneficial for all of them.
I think we're ready because I think if we learn earlier, we'll be much more comfortable.
Well, today was our first day of banking here at Jacob Hiatt. We had a great turnout. The students were amazing. They weren't sure as to what was going to happen, so we tried to help them out a little bit with their little green pouches. So when they come to banking, they bring us their little green pouch. Their green pouch is what they travel back and forth from school to banking to make their deposits. They give us the pouch, and they get to choose a sticker while they're waiting. We look over their deposit to make sure that it's filled out correctly, and then they get to choose a sticker. We give them their little punch, and they get to either choose a prize or earn prizes as they go along.
I haven't had a bank account in a long time, and I want to see how it feels to have my own bank account at the school.
I play Fortnite, and it's like online. I can't pay with actual cash, so like it's easier, like, because I use my money and my mom uses her credit card, and I give her the money that I have, so it's going to be easier for me if I could just do it myself.
It's going to be like nice doing banking because students can learn how to save when they're younger instead of like spending all their money.
What I hope to do with that money is a lot of things. Like probably give it to charity or probably use it for my dad's bills.
If I had money, I would buy a house for my family.
I would save it for college and getting a car and all that stuff.
I'll give some to my family, and then I'll save the rest for places for people who don't have enough money, like maybe kids' hospitals.
You're all set. Thank you.
We got about what? 26, 36 today?
Roughly, yeah,
about 36. And we didn't really know what to expect today. Usually today's the first day, and usually it's kind of stagnant. But today we got a lot of deposits today.
We did. We had a great turnout today. You're welcome. Nice manners.
Hopefully our partnership lasts for many years to come.
Workshop is a sea glass window workshop. I have a small business called Coastal Window Workshop where people make a sea glass window using a wood frame, and they have shells, starfish, urchins, driftwood, coral, crushed shells, glass, different color sand. People can make their own design, or they can use a template if they don't feel creative or want to do on their own. I have some templates that people can use. People seem to enjoy it. Done this a couple of other adult education, and now we're bringing it to Worcester. So that's very exciting. And we hope to come back in the fall and have a bigger crowd.
We're very excited to have it here at Worcester Technical High School. We had very short notice setting it up, and 14 people signed up, which we think is great. We expect more in the fall. People just come out, they brought their friends, and people came in groups of three or four and just are making artistic pieces that they'd love to have in the house. So we're really excited to have it here.
It was fun. We came with friends, and the people all here are nice, and it's kind of interactive with the ladies. We all had a good time laughing, and it kind of exceeded my expectations. She had a lot of good materials that we could use, and I brought a few of my own, some of my own sand dollars from Hampton Beach by Hampton Beach Sand. So it worked out good.
And I'll tell you this before you go home, you'll take them off, you'll pour your chemicals, and then wait about 10 minutes and you'll just drop them on.
Yeah, I think it's WorcesterNightLife.org. Look online, and when they put up their fall classes, hopefully we'll have one or two next fall. And I look forward to meeting everybody.
So he said, I guess I'm not one to hear anymore. So he chose to leave this book. He chose to end his life because of the boys.
This day was a celebration for Ty Smalley, who whose parents created the Stand for the Silent organization. The students know about Ty Smalley and how he was bullied and what he chose to do about that. Unfortunately, the kids were very saddened by that as well.
3 years ago at a bullying conference in the Worcester Public Schools, Mr. Kirk Smalley, father of Ty, came and spoke to over 350 educators about Stand for the Silent. Mr. Smalley had a very big emotional impact on the attendees at the conference as he talked about the struggles his son had in regards to being bullied before he tragically took his life one day. Mr. Smalley recalled how his wife went home that day and found Ty, who had committed suicide in their home.
You know, I got a phone call that day at 2:39. Caller ID said that it was Laura, so I answered. Colleen, you know, she was screaming. She was just screaming. I couldn't even understand a single word that she was trying to say to me. She just screamed and screamed. Finally, I screamed back at her. I told her, baby, you gotta stop. You gotta tell me what's going on. And she managed to say, he's dead. He shot himself. You know, I actually asked her who. She said, Ty.
So with our celebration, we're hoping that kids who are bullied will stand up and be able to say what's on their mind, and the friends around them also to be able to say what's on their mind and help the silent, which are those children who are being bullied and don't have the voice to speak up.
Where and when bullying happens. Bullying can occur during or in after school hours.
While most reported bullying happens in the school building,
a significant percentage also happens in places like on the playground or the bus.
It can also happen traveling to or from school.
It was a very exciting and inspirational assembly of what the young kids need to be reminded of, and it's narrowed down to the respect for who they are and their friends, speaking, communication, and the connection between all of them as kids in one school. They had posters and they celebrated who they were and who their friends were. It doesn't get much better than that. So it was quite an inspirational morning.
We watched the Bully Project. Every day Ms. Rogan selects a student to do Stand for the Silent pledge.
Okay, here we go.
We pledge from this day forward.
We promise to respect those around us.
us well, respect ourselves. We are somebody.
And we can make a difference. We can make another feel loved.
As others try to spread hatred through our community,
we could be the helping hands that lead another path
to the path of hope and aspiration. We will not stand silent.
Instead, we pledge to lift up the victims and show them that
their life matters. We will be the change because
we are somebody.
So it's kind of just becoming embedded in the culture of the school. And this was just a great way to showcase everything that's been going on all year. So many teachers pitched in to help, and so many kids were all excited about it. And we're just glad that it all came together.
It's not necessarily that there's a problem here, but kids have to learn it so that they can look out for others, that they see it going on in the playground, they see it going on maybe at church or in a mall or wherever they see it. We want them well informed as to what bullying looks like.
Anytime students have an opportunity to share their ideas and their thoughts, it's always an impact. That means they're thinking about the consequences or their actions. So we always think that for students to have the opportunity to discuss and share with their peers. In this case, bullying was the topic, and students were able to kind of share their experiences and talk about how they felt about bullying.